What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com and I am back once again with another PLSQL tutorial. Today in this tutorial, we will learn how to create a table based record in Oracle database. We have already discussed topics like what are records and their types along with the syntax of creating records in previous PLSQL tutorial. I suggest you to watch that tutorial, find the link in the description. So without wasting much of your time, let's start the tutorial. So as we already know that record data type variables are composite data structures made up of different components called fields, which have the same name and data types as that of the columns of a table using which you created the record. So let's do the examples and learn how to declare a record data type variable and retrieve data from it. But before that, let's quickly go over a simple example of select into statement, which we have previously seen in PLSQL tutorial 3. Here in this PLSQL program, as you can see, we have declared two variables, v underscore fname and v underscore salary. Both these variables have different data types and data weights. And in the execution section of this block, we used both these variables for storing the data of the employee whose ID is 200 from corresponding columns of employees table. So what we understand from this program is that we need to create variables which have same data type and data weights to store the data retrieved from the columns of the table. As we have here, variable v underscore fname for first name column and v underscore salary for salary column. This sounds very simple and practical, especially when we know the structure of the table and we are sure that no one will ever change it over which we have programmed our code or say the app. But what if we don't know the structure of the table, or one day someone in your company decides to change the data type or data width of the salary column of this table? Then this program will become useless. In fact, not only this program, but every other PLSQL program which is based on this table is useless. So what is the solution? The answer is very simple. The solution of this problem is database record data type variables. So let's see how database records can help us in dealing with our problem. First, let me open a fresh worksheet. Now let's do the example of record type variables in Oracle database. Here we have the declaration section of this anonymous PLSQL block where we declared our record type variable. Declaration of a record variable is very similar to the declaration of a simple user variables. First, we have the name of the variable, which is v underscore emp. You can give whatever name you want to your variable. Then we have the name of the table, which is employees in our case, over which we want to declare our record variable. And then we have the percentage row type attribute, which indicates that the declared variable is a record type variable. Whenever you declare a record type variable, Oracle engine will declare a composite data structure with fields corresponding to each column of the specified table. This means that if we have a record variable created using employees table, then that variable has 11 fields corresponding to 11 columns of the employees table. Also, all these fields have the same name, data type, and data width as of the columns of the table. So let's move ahead and write the execution section. This execution section is almost self-explanatory. Here again, we have a select into statement, but this time we are selecting data of an employee with employee ID 200 from all the columns of employees table. And unlike the previous example, we used only one variable, v underscore emp, which is the record type variable for storing all this data. On execution of this select into statement, all the data of the employee with employee ID 200 will be stored into the respective fields of this record type variable, which is v underscore emp. So that is how we initialize a record variable. So now we have seen how to declare and initialize a record variable. The only thing which remains unanswered is how to access data from the records. So let's complete this execution block and learn how to access data of a record. In this output statement, we have displayed the first name and salary of the desired employee. Let's see how. In order to access the data stored into a record variable, we use the dot notation, in which we first write the name of our record variable, followed by a dot, and then the name of the column whose data we want to retrieve. Such as, in this example, we displayed the first name of the employee, and for that we first wrote the name of the record variable, followed by a dot, and then the name of the column, which is first name. And similarly, we retrieved the salary of the employee. Using this way, you can retrieve the data of the desired employee from any column of the table. For example, along with the first name and salary, you also want to see the hiring date of the employee. For that, either just add the column into this output statement or add an extra DBMS output statement. That's all you have to do. Now let's execute this code and see the output. Here is the name, salary, and hire date of the employee whose employee ID is 200. That is a brief PL SQL video tutorial on record data type variables in Oracle database. There are few more things related to this topic which you can learn from my blog on record data type variables in Oracle database. Please do check that. Find the link on your screen and also in the description down below. That's it for today. Do make sure to subscribe, as I will be back soon with another interesting tutorial. If you want to stay in touch with me, then follow me on my Twitter, Facebook, or on Instagram. All the links are in the description. And if you want to help me, then simply help others in learning by sharing this video on your social media. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. I will be back soon. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.